I was living on my own, had my own apartment, had my own car. I was independent going forward in my life. I was 21 when I decided to move from Pagosa Springs, Colorado to Colorado Springs. I loved hiking and fishing, hunting, going out with friends, all the stuff that someone your age would do. Then in a blink of an eye, everything changed for me drastically. In March of 2014, I had just moved to Colorado Springs a month before my accident. That night, I was at a movie with friends, and I was driving home at about 10:30 p.m. when a girl who was texting and driving didn't notice the red light ahead of her. She T-boned me on the passenger side of my vehicle. It set my car, it flipped my car. It scooted my car across the intersection, basically whipping it, and it was only stopped because of the divider on the opposite end. I lost consciousness, so the next thing I remember was the girl opening my door and all the smoke flying out of my car. The first thing I thought to do was to find my phone, my dad. I was only two blocks from my house at the time. Thankfully, the fire station was right around the corner, so they were able to hear us, and all the police came right away, because we were the only two out there on the road at the time. Through all that commotion, I just remember my mangled vehicle being towed away from the scene. And that was my first car I'd ever bought myself, so that was a hard moment. She admitted to me that she was texting and driving and didn't see the red light ahead of her. I hope that none of you have ever had to go through the process of filing a police report or an accident report. It takes a very long time, not to mention how long it takes to talk to your insurance company. When my vehicle was hit,